Good evening. What a wonderful location to be here, speaking to the Minister of Tourism, Vishwendra Singh, here in Jaipur. Thank you so much for being here with
Thank
us.
You, ma'am. Pleasure.
I wanted to, you know, you have to think when you're sitting in a place like this, why does Rajasthan Tourism need selling at all? I mean, it sells itself, doesn't it?
Ma'am, as we heard in the previous debate, good evening, ladies and gentlemen, first. And we have an ex-minister who's been
yes.
Minister of Tourism four times.
Yeah.
So now the main thing is that Rajasthan, as we said in the last debate we heard, is only 5% has been tapped. Now what I intend to do now, the ministry intends to do, is to make new circuits, like what the lady from the audience asked, asking Mr. Pilot. But we have to make these circuits which are sort of integrated with religion, wildlife, archaeology, and we have to make them in a way where people are, they are accessible to people. Like, for instance, I will, since the MLA was sitting here from Dholpur, I'm in minister in charge of Dholpur. I went to Dholpur the other day and I was thinking to myself, why these people just drive past? Why can't we make a new circuit here, which includes wildlife, which includes history, which includes heritage also. So Dholpur is a small place, and there is a sanctuary called Van Vihar there, which is the highest number of sloth bears in Rajasthan, over 12. So if that is converted into a sloth bear sanctuary, you see the sloth bear sanctuary, you see, then go to Talab-e-Shahi, the hunting lodge of Emperor Akbar. You see, there's a beautiful monument and temple, Machkund. Then you see the Dargah, of that's optional, who wants to go. And you finish the day by a safari on the Chambal River and see the Gharials and then rest in a beautiful tented camp. So this is the kind of thing what the ministry is now pushing forward for. And we're inviting lots of advice from a lot of the people who are in the industry and from people in general. But we need to create new circuits. As Mr. Pilot said, the Golden Triangle is there. Mm. And Jodhpur and Udaipur is there. But would you like to come back again to see the same things again? No. Whether you're an Indian national or a foreign person or a foreign national, you'd like to see something new.
Well, do you think that's the reason why, despite all of these places in Rajasthan, which are iconic, they've been in Hollywood movies, they've been Bollywood movies. I mean, people keep playing the same scenes of James Bond, Udaipur. So do you think it's because of what you're saying that we're not seeing the kind of footfalls that places internationally, which don't have that much heritage, they get that, for example, Bangkok or, you know, Sri Lanka or other places? Is it because of this kind of, you know, lack of newer circuits?
We definitely need newer circuits, as I said. And the newer circuits will only come once we try and find them. Now, there was a slogan in the last government, which cost the exchequer 9 crores, because the government wanted to oblige a particular company. And it was said, kab kaha dik, kya dik jaye? What does that mean?
That wasn't a good one, you thought?
I mean, I don't want to say in front of everybody, you can see anything 50 feet away.
She seems to be taking it good spirit, of course, yeah. Yeah.
So, I mean, I don't want to do the unmentionables
yeah.
on stage, but you can understand what I mean. So, let's be realistic. We want to make people welcome. We have to increase our infrastructure. And through this conclave, I'd like to also request the central government to raise its aid for India, for Rajasthan.
Hmm.
Now, under the Swadesh Brahman Yatra, they're giving out 48 crores. I was taking a prize the other day. On the 25th, we were given a prize for a heritage rock in Jodhpur by the center, Mr. Alphonse. And he says, I can't. I said, he says, what do you need? I said, I need funds. And he had, I mean, I don't want to sound rude, but he said, no, your proposals have arrived late. My principal secretary is sitting right here. She was, in fact, our officials were in an official meeting with his officials. So if we are going to play politics, just because we are a Congress-ruled state, and we have a BJP government at the center at the moment, and be deprived of funds, I think that will be very sad for Rajasthan and for the whole of the country.
So you anticipate that?
I anticipate absolutely.
So how does one get around it? Because we are seeing, I mean, this is a...
Just don't get a BJP government.
Okay, so this is we're pitching for 2019 elections over
yes.
here as well. Okay, great. No, so I wanted to ask you, if you're speaking about 2019 elections, one of the things, of course, and tourism, I want to ask about that. One of the things that, you know, the Prime Minister, they were talking, Sachin Pilot was also speaking about this, about job creation. One of the things, yardsticks that the Prime Minister talked about when he talks about job creation, he talked about the increasing number of hotels. Now, I wanted to ask you, do you agree with his perspective? He said, look, it's unfair for people to say there are no jobs because the number of hotels have increased and that shows the number of job creation. He gave that as a yardstick, even though we don't really have specific numbers. Would you accept, being in a tourism hub like Rajasthan, that yes, there is a lot of job creation with increasing number of hotels?
Ma'am, again coming, it's all coming back again. Back to the circuits. The more hotels we have, the more jobs will be created. That is one, it was very correct. But the point is that the government, we have the tourism department, and we have the Rajasthan Tourism Development Corporation, and we have several hotels all over the state, which are our bleeding point. Let me be very honest. Because...
You're talking about RTDC hotels.
I'm talking about RTDC. And that's where employment comes in. And the RTDC, the 5 years the government did nothing for these hotels. And they're in deplorable condition. And in fact, that is our bleeding point. And unless we try and revive that. So the first thing I did was, because there was always a dispute between the union leaders and the government officials and the government. 5 years they did nothing. Meena ji was there, she tried, she did a lot for it. But after that, it's collapsed. This is tourism ministry in the last 5 years, the BJP government was put on the back burner. What we intend to do, the first meeting I had with the union leaders, how we can get more properties going. Half our properties are lying closed. So employment automatically will rise if we get these properties going. And in fact, we have...
Are you saying they're lying closed even though there is a need for
yes,
more hotels in the state?
Because they are in such deplorable condition because of lack of funds and the lack of interest of the last government that we just can't sort of cope with it. So we will have to eventually go on the PPP mode, sell some of them. We'll have to outsource some of them. In fact, and... upgrade the heritage properties, beautiful properties we have. City State in Alwar, we have Jhumar Bawari in Ranthambore, we have Anand Bhavan in, I'm giving you examples, in Udaipur. They are heritage properties, Khasa Koti in Jaipur.
No, so what's the stumbling block?
So now the stumbling block is that once we get our finances correct, which is very important, and if the center is kind enough to give us aid, then we can, what the Prime Minister wants, more jobs, is buy more hotels. I agree, if you have more hotels, obviously there will be more jobs. Get our old hotels going and make the tourism policy, we are making a new tourism policy in Rajasthan also, which will be more tourism friendly, tourist friendly, and tourism friendly for the hotel people. And we hope to come out of the red very soon. But we will definitely need central assistance, and that is a must. And it'd be injustice to Rajasthan if such a petty thing is done just because we have a Congress government here that our funds are slashed.
Can I ask you something? Because, you know, this keeps popping up every time you speak to state governments and, you know, ministers like yourself about why is it that we're not getting our share of world tourism boom? Why aren't we getting that money? And one of the things that I'm going to refer to two ministers. One of the things that, for example, in Goa, one of the Goa ministers said, he said there's a problem with the kind of domestic tourists that we get. You know, they behave very badly. And it led to a lot of talk at that time about the way that Indian tourists behave, or perhaps people, the kind of reception that people get over here with, you know, the locals, how they view foreigners, how they view women, things like that. It's something that also you mentioned KJ Alphonse. It's something that he mentioned as well, that there is a certain way that you have to, you know, you have to mind local customs and cultures and things like that. Do you think these attitudes are impacting the way people view India and deter women from coming?
I think Rajasthan is far more civilized than the states you just took the names off. And I think the people are much more politer here and more tourist friendly. And we look everywhere, whether it's the upper strata or the lowest rung, we all look forward to tourists coming. We welcome them. And Atithi Devo Bhava is there, as you know, and Padharo Mare Desh is our slogan. And we can't be more welcoming than that. And I think, yes, in some places there are nuisance, some people, but for that, what we are planning to do is have tourism policing, which is very important, so that people are not harassed unnecessarily. But generally, I think Rajasthan people are more welcoming than anywhere else. I mean, I may sound prejudiced, but that is what it is.
And in, you know, even when they land, I think some of the linkages, when you land in Delhi in order to come over here, the whole safety factor, that could, don't you agree, if that is fixed, then that will lead to many more people coming. And single women traveling.
That I agree, absolutely. That's why I said that tourism policing is a must. I mean, if the bus is coming, you put two marshals on board, I'm sure the guests will feel much safer. And it's not a very big thing to do. But then the point is that the states and the union government need to sit together and work out what we want to do for tourism in India, not only in Rajasthan, and how we can make the tourist feel protected, feel happy, feel welcome, and comfortable in every which way.
Well, you said that religion plays a huge, is a factor in this as well, the religious tourism.
Yes.
That, is that something that people are really kind of, you know, because we've seen the Kumbh right now, it's being marketed. In fact, if you look at it, the whole 2019 campaign, a lot of it, actually, it was the launch pad for the 2019 campaign for the BJP.
Yes.
Wouldn't you agree?
I agree.
So tell us about that. What is happening with religious tourism?
Now, that is exactly what I'm trying to say, that there is, we have not tapped it enough. Religious tourism in Rajasthan, there's so much scope for it. And next door, like, I come from Bharatpur. Now, Vrindavan, Govardhan, and Mathura are 30 kilometers away from Bharatpur. And we can, what my intention is, that every district in Rajasthan, we have 33, should have one night stay for tourists to see that new circuit. And a divisional headquarter like Bharatpur should have at least two. Like the Fatehpur Sikri is closer to Bharatpur than it is to Agra. Agra is 50 kilometers away. You see the bird sanctuary, you see Fatehpur Sikri, you see the Taj, you visit the Red Fort, come back, spend the night in Bharatpur. Next day, you go to, on a religious thing, you start the Deek Palaces, which are a living Fatehpur Sikri, you go to Govardhan, you go to Mathura, Vrindavan, come back, spend the night. So what we're trying to do is we're trying to attract religious tourists as well. But it's interesting if you mix them all together with wildlife, whether it's religion and archaeological sites. So yeah, that makes it an interesting combination.
Before, you know, we can take a couple of audience questions, I'm told, and sure, I definitely want to hear from Veena Kak as well. But I just wanted to ask you that one of the big problems in Rajasthan, of course, and, you know, this is what, in being in the national media, this is something we're constantly reporting as a story, is the Gujar agitation. Isn't that a problem that keeps popping up?
I dealt with it, and the government was very swift, and it ended peacefully, and it's, I think, God willing, finished forever.
We're not going to see it popping up in the next 5 years at all.
You won't see it.
That's a welcome news for everyone. And how much do you think? How much do you think the 10% quota and reservations is going to play in the 2019 election? How much of a factor?
Matt, this has been going on for years and years and years. In fact, I was the one who was the only member of parliament in 1989 who resigned on the subject. I said the economically deprived should also be given 10% resignation. I resigned from Lok Sabha on that in 89. But I was a lone voice. But now everybody's singing, and the Prime Minister himself is a...
That's before the Mandal agitation, yes, and all of that.
During that period. Mm. So this 10% is...
Do you think it will impact the Congress's fortunes?
No, I don't think, not at all, because it's a very old story. Everybody's been asking for it. I don't think it impact anything at all. What it would definitely impact the BJP, mm-hmm, is the false promises that they made. Where is the crores and crores and crores of black money that was supposed to filter into this country?
Yeah.
And we brought back, and the accused people brought back. Now nobody's been brought back. And distributed into accounts of 15 lakhs, up to 15 lakhs into poor people's account. Not even 15 paise is gone. What about employment? 2 crore jobs will be given. Why can you please ask the audience, even if they know anybody who's even got, 2 people have got jobs from on that on basis. So it's just a propaganda. As Mr. Pirate said, that they're very good at propaganda, okay, which I agree with them.
Let's get in some questions. And could we have a mic for ma'am, please? Ma'am, do you want to say anything about some of the things that he mentioned?
No, I agree with the minister that new circuits have to be opened. And Dholpur, of course, is one absolutely virgin destination. And there is Harothi, Bundi, Jhalawad, where Mrs. Rajay comes from. In the last 5 years, nothing much was done there. I mean, the palaces of Bundi, Jhalawad,
Kota. Why do you think nothing was done?
The interest, she wasn't concerned about tourism, was a very low priority. There were other things, jahan unka wo kaam karna chahti thi. So there's pilgrimage tourism, as you said, there is Pushkar, there is Khwaja Gharib Nawaz in Ajmer, there is Baba Ramdev. So in sab cheezon ko you have to explore these. Except for snow, we have everything else. We have the hills, we have the history, culture, music, archaeology, wildlife. What else do we need? Every 60 miles the language changes.
And you accept that the central government may be petty because there's a...
They have been petty. You know, I've been minister 4 times. We used to always be fighting with them. Paisa dijiye. So every third tourist coming to India is coming to Rajasthan. So I'm glad the minister has a good team now. I have my state minister for tourism who's sitting next to me, and I... State Minister for Tourism who's sitting next to me, and I wish you all the very best.
Thank you, ma'am. We really need it. No, we need all your advice and guidance.
Because you are from the royal family, the history, you yourself have a beautiful palace, and a very rich area that you are living in. So all the very best. Thank you.
Thank you so much.
I wanted to ask you, before we take another, does anyone else have a question? Okay. The mic at the back, please. I just wanted to ask you, what about, you know, you talked about wildlife. Is there a problem in, you know, people love going to Ranthambore because there are more chances of seeing tigers over there. But is there conflict of how much you open it up and, you know, concerns about the wildlife?
May I be very honest?
Yeah.
Ranthambore is one place, one national park, which has got 2 kinds of mafia. Tourist mafia and the hotel mafia, forest mafia. And I'm glad the minister is clapping on it. Because we have people sitting there who have got hotels there, who have been connected to, who are allegedly connected to the top people in the parties. And they this mafia has to be stopped. The tourism mafia, I will kill in the next 6 months.
What do you mean mafia? What do they do?
It's a tourist mafia. I mean, you have to be there to see it. You must do a report on it. In fact, NDTV should do a report on the mafia, the tourist mafia, how the common man is harassed in Ranthambore, and how favoritism is done to people. And some hotels, their cars are allowed to go into zones which are prohibited. But just because they have influence. And those same notorious people have again had the cheek to help trying to get themselves on the board of the forest department again. I would call it really, really, really cheeky of them. And, but forest is not with me, so I can't say on that.
Right.
But tourist mafia, I will smash. That is, I can guarantee you that.
Wow. Yeah, the question at the back. Yes, sir.
Your Highness, I've got two questions.
Please,
one is, during your previous government, Jaipur veranda got cleared. That was a miracle. Now, second is, we have a tourism point which is dead now, the Ramgarh Lake. If you can do that miracle again with the government, it will be a great help to the industry.
That's a very nice question. I mean, a very important question as well. And we will go all out. And I would be grateful if you could drop by one day and we can discuss it over a cup of tea and how we go to go about it.
Yeah.
What was the second one?
Hello.
Yes, go ahead.
Second was that during Madam Binaji's time, yeah, and previous time also, we had one window for tourism. Art, culture, forest, tourism, all was at one place. Today we have got art and culture separate, forest separate, and tourism separate. If through this program, and if all the other two departments can come under your umbrella and you can handle yourself, it will be a great help to tourism, because you understand tourism very well. You have donated such a large forest for the bird sanctuary also. Your family has done it. So you understand what forest is, tourism and art and culture. So it will be great.
Sir, portfolios are the prerogative of the Chief Minister.
I request Chief Minister through this okay, talk.
Thank you.
The last, the lady at the back, yeah. And here, go ahead.
I should make a disclosure. I'm from NDTV, but Vishwendra ji, I just wanted to ask a question.
Please.
I'm an outsider. I don't know Rajasthan. But my sense of Rajasthan is that the families who are rooted here, the people of Rajasthan, have been the greatest enablers of tourism facilities in the state. They have orchestrated their homes and the experiences in a manner that attract tourists. My question to you is simply twofold. Does the RTDC need to manage properties at all? Because you seem to have talent within the state for good management. And the second question is, what is the feedback that your relatively new government has got from those, and there are many in the audience, who are running heritage properties and in a sense, contributing to the tourism cause? What are they seeking from you? Let's keep infrastructure and funds in a separate bucket for the purpose of this question.
Ma'am, I'll be very honest. As far as your first part of the question is about the RTDC hotels, from what I gather, what I understand you're asking, is whether they should be closed down or not. What I'm trying to say, that we definitely need to upgrade the heritage properties that are owned by the RTDC. And there are several of them, which I had quoted. Now, yes, of course, we need to go on PPP mode. I've told them we need to outright sell some, which even if we put 10 crores into a place like Dosa Midway, we can never make money on it. But somebody has to take the decision. And the last government just sat on it and took no decisions. So that is the problem. And as far as the Heritage Association is concerned, I think it's a wonderful, wonderful job they're doing. And they are enhancing every day the culture, what Rajasthan is all about. And I admire the Heritage Association. And also we will try and imbibe that into the RTDC as much as we can, by restoring these beautiful old heritage buildings and properties we own.
So it really sounds like you have your task cut out for you.
Well, yeah, but the point is, we need central aid.
Yeah.
for that.
I think the message has gone across really strong. Thank you so much.
Thank you.
We're totally out of time.
It's not a question. It's a wish that you mentioned tourism policing. Please follow it up. That's a very good concept.
Yeah. Thank you, ma'am.
All the best.
Thank you.
Thank you, Vishwendra Singh Ji. Thank you so much for speaking to NDTV.